that drip for free. You know you got power. Ain't trying to throw the home bag at me. Oh yeah, I know I got power. I got power. What you saying to me? I got power. I said, put in the hours.
Look at you. Face down on the floor. I told you, you don't have it.
Welcome aboard, everybody. This is Wednesday Night Basketball of the NBA on 2K Sports. Kevin Harlan here, joined by our analyst, Greg Anthony, and Hall of Famer Doris Burke. Plus, reporting from the sidelines, another Hall of Famer, David Aldridge. And taking a broader look here at the year-over-year scoring trend for Harrison Barnes.
And looking at his offensive numbers from the past few years, it seems like teams around the league have kind of figured him out. He's having to work a lot harder for his points, and he hasn't been coming nearly as easily as they used to.
Now Sacramento starting five. Barnes is in the front court along with Murray. Fox in the backcourt with Herter to his side. And it's Sabonis in at center. And for the Hornets, Rozier's out there with Miller. Then it's Martin. Then there's Miles Bridges. And it's Williams at the center filling out the middle. They'll have their work cut out for them in this one, Doris. As we know, teams typically don't play as well on the second night of a back-to-back.
You're right, Kevin, because that all comes down to fatigue. A rested team obviously has an advantage over a team playing the second in as many nights. The numbers always back that up.
Now Rozier. Going inside. Here's Bridges. The shot goes in. First shot, first basket.
You're starting to be able to trust that Terry Rozier is going to make these finds.
Looked loose. Here's Fox. A shot that time, not on target. Some solid defense from Rozier. A tray. Rebound by Murray. And Murray's got the ball here for the Kings. They put up a nice win against Detroit the last time out.
And sometimes it's a lot harder to get easy looks on the road, but they found ways to get their guys good looks.
Well, they knew exactly how to approach that defense. They shot a fantastic percentage because they got quality looks.
And the basket by Rozier.
What pretty move by Rozier. He's forced into the floater. What touch right there.
We always see Terry Rozier going all out, don't we, Greg, to make an impact offensively.
Kevin, I just love the way his offensive repertoire has evolved over the years. This guy came in as just a hard-nosed, tough defender, but great offensively. His skill set and development on that end is off the chart.
Boy, you love what this guy is doing right now. He's taking smart shots and shooting a high percentage start.
Hornets have gone 3-4 from the field to start off the game. Bridges passes to Martin. Rozier kicks to Martin. Miller dishes to Bridges. And a great assist by Miller. That one goes in.
And not just the score. Miller can dish it as well, showing great vision on that play.
And a deep three from Fox. And the rebound goes to the Hornets.
Boy, at some point you've got to realize there might be a better option standing next to you. This guy has not made one basket in this period.
Now, here's Rozier. He's got five. Down low. And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading defensive to a score. Just great ball movement.
And a look now at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the Hornets.
And right from the jump, they've been working hard to establish themselves inside, using agility and power to get shots in the paint.
Yeah, and in addition, their ball movement has really unleashed their offense. Boy, they've been fun to watch.
And so it's Charlotte with it. The Kings getting the bucket. Out to Bridges. There's the three. Good on the three-point shot. Bridges got his third basket of the night right there.
And you can't help but pick their defense apart. They're completely in disarray.
Here's Fox, and there's the drive. Who's back in? Sabonis with the bucket.
Boy, that could have been an empty possession, but Sabonis, hustle on the glass, turns it into a couple of points.
There's the call on Kevin Herter. That's his first foul.
Personal foul. Second team foul.
Williams with the ball. He's making his presence felt offensively with his scoring average up there at almost 13 points a game. Now, here's Rozier. They're leading by 8 on the clock.
And despite that miss, a strong start for them offensively.
No good from the wing. Boy, doesn't Mike Brown, GA, deserve a lot of credit for the Kings' recent success. He's been terrific. Here's Williams.
2 minutes remaining in the first. 2 minutes.
And there's the pass to Rozier. Charity scrap shot. Bridges finds Rozier. Nice open look, but it's no good.
Boy, he was wide open. You wonder, did he overthink it? That's a missed opportunity.
Fox, he scores, and he's off the schneid with that basket. 1 for 7 on a tough night for him.
About time he got one to fall there for that 6 straight misses to start this one.
Now, here's Rozier. 5 points in the game. And here is Bridges. Let's go. Sabonis grabs the board.
And that's where you want to make the next pass. This guy is a good scorer, but the defense was right on him.
Herter kicks to Fox. Another miss by Fox. So Rozier will bring it up with the Hornets. They're leading by 8. Travel to Sacramento last time they faced the Kings and came away with a win.
And they got the better of this matchup last time with their defensive pressure and the ability to force turnover.
Yeah, I thought the giveaways were a tremendous factor. They were taking some chances on D, jumping in the passing, that sort of thing. And it really paid off for them.
How about the awareness there from Fox? You got to love seeing how he is such a willing passer in finding the open man.
Now, here's Rozier. 7 points in the game. Williams finds Rozier. Charlotte moving it around. Williams with the stuff.
We've seen some fireworks from them already.
Well, what I love is the game plan is solid from the opening tip. Guys are making their shots. That's critical.
Fox passes to Rozier. From deep, Herter. And the rebound goes to the Hornets. Outplayed in the previous game on their schedule, losing to Chicago.
Yeah, I mean, hard time shooting a rock in that one. But they also didn't give themselves the best look.
I think even when you get quality looks, there was an inability to stay consistent. It was hard to win a cold shooting night in today's NBA. The scoring is just too good.
And an overpowering first quarter effort. Already a double-digit advantage. It's Charlotte up 10. We'll be back shortly live from Spectrum Center. And welcome back to the second quarter of action. Plenty of basketball left to play, but this one has been one-sided so far. Looking at what we've seen from the Hornets, what do you think?
Playing inside out in that first quarter led to some high percentage shots in the paint.
It is great when you can get that established early, because to me it opens up every other aspect of your game.
The Kings trail by 10. Washington out there with Nick Richards. Then there's Terry Rozier, Mike Smith, and it's McGowan's in the small forward position. So that's the group out there for Charlotte. To the paint, here's Richards. Takes it off the glass. Richards got the lead at the 12 now for the Hornets.
Yeah, that was the third straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. And the defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
I'll say it feels all night like this guy's been forcing shots, rushing shots. He's really struggling on the offensive end.
And with an update from the sideline, let's check in with David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. For Hornets coach Steve Clifford, the key is defense. He says trying to outscore other teams doesn't work. You have to do the things that take effort. Rebounding, hitting loose balls, and putting your body on the line. You've got to build a game that will actually work at the end of the year when you play the important games. Kevin, back to you.
All right, D.A., our thanks to you. Alex Lenz checked in for Sacramento. Rozier against Fox. McCollum's no good. The Kings trail by 12. The Wilds puts up a deep three. And he's good on the three ball. Wilds got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Hornets are gone 1-3 to start out the second quarter. And when it comes to the Charlotte Hornets, this is a squad that wants to keep getting better, too.
Kevin, it shows you how challenging success and sustained success in particular is. This is an organization that has had pockets of success in the past. But the keys to this are you drafting well? Are you developing young talent? Have you built out a culture? Do you have top-down leadership that trickles through an organization? This is something Charlotte has to think about.
So Charlotte calls timeout. They're first. Six. Got it. Good job in the low post. Rozier's got 9 points.
Rozier in amongst the trees. Gets that one to go.
Murray outside. Good. And a nice assist from Fox. Fox has got his third assist on the night.
Their third three-pointer in a row.
Rozier kicks to Miller. Takes the three. Rebound by the Kings. Second quarter of play with almost 3 minutes gone. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. And neither defensive money players. Great save. Man, everything is a foul now. They can't even touch the guy. He can't defend. And do they have a point?
It's getting tough. You have to be set. It's almost like they want defenders to be traffic cones.
Williams is checked in for the Hornets. Well, the last time GA the Hornets made the playoffs was back in 2016.
And that was during Steve Clifford's first stint with the organization. I'm sure that played a factor in their decision to bring him back as head coach.
That's a dozen straight points coming off the triple.
Martin. Here's Miller. That's it. He's got two more now. He's shooting two for three.
And Hornets of Jumpsie is very good around the rim. Rare quality for a wing these days.
So the Kings call timeout. They're first. Bridges checks in.
And with the pause here, how about the stats for Bridges? He's getting around 20 points per, 7 rebounds, and 3 assists. He's been nothing short of fantastic during that stretch. Offense coming very easily for him.
And so much of it to me is his ability to read the floor, make the right decision. decision and then go right after the action he wants.
Miller dishes to Bridges. From the stripe. Rebound by the Kings.
Well, if the defense gives him that shot next time, they could get burned. I think he's just a little bit out of rhythm.
Not a tough start scoring the basketball, but they're starting to turn it around.
And some changes in for the Kings. Sabonis, he's checked in for Trey Lyles. And it's Barnes in for Malik Monk. The Kings shoot their third free throw attempt of the game. A free throw off from Fox.
I really love Fox's game. He's got a ton of room to grow. But boy, does he play with intensity.
And it's Miller in the corner. Williams inside. Sabonis is there. Williams can't hit.
Most of the time, this guy's going to finish that, but that was tremendous defense that prohibits him from completing the play. This guy cannot get started, and the offense overall has been a struggle because of it.
Martin, the pass to Miller. Bridges outside. To the inside. Williams. Count the bucket coming off a perfectly placed assist. Williams has got six.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference. And points in the paint between the two teams.
And there it is for you.
He is a blur. I mean, Fox obviously skilled at breaking down the defense, coupled with his athleticism and size. Boy, he is a terror.
Miller dishes to Williams. That's in, coming off an assist from Miller. Miller's got his third assist on the night.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Three-pointer, Fox. Another miss by Fox.
No idea why he's attempting so many outside shots. It's not his day, and he needs to either look to drive or get it to an open teammate.
Williams gets to Washington. And the three off target. They can go 2-for-1.
It's about being smart right now.
Pass to Barnes. A three. That's in. He found his range with that one. Now 1-for-2.
The improvement in Barnes' deep range just helps his offense space the floor.
Pass to Bridges. That's good. And it's his fourth basket of the game. He's a strong 4-for-6.
Well, the advantage they have right now is largely based on his play. What an outstanding night.
Back to Fox. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. He's got eight.
And Fox starting to show you his abilities inside. It has quick instincts, which I think helps him when he's down low.
Williams finds Washington. All three off the mark. So that'll be it for the first half. Fairly even battle underway in this one. Hornets lead by 4. And we'll be back right after halftime to get the third quarter underway. 31.
Thanks for stopping by, y'all. First up on the show tonight, a quick look ahead of some upcoming games on the docket. Always nice to take a look ahead. Kenny, you ever take a look ahead?
Well, sometimes I look at Zach's bald head over there. It's shining.
That's because I stay well moisturized.
Okay.
That is vital, Shaq. Vital. And let's take a look at this first half of play for the Kings. Not a lot of separation here at the midway point.
I think to win this game, they have to step up defensively, get nasty, touch them up, make them work for everything they get.
Letting your opponent shoot over 50%, rarely a recipe for success in this league. Thank you for being with us. Now let's send it to Kevin Harlan for the second half tip.
Just joining us, we've played through the first half in a game that's been fairly even so far. Nice game. Great performance by Terry Rozier.
Man, he's been running wild on him through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
Boy, he has been shouldering the load. Aggressive, skilled, talented, and thus far unstoppable.
Second half underway. Here's what Mike Brown's got on the floor. Sabonis is the center with Murray next to him. Herder and Barnes are your wingmen. And it's Fox in at the point. Martin with it. And now by Barnes. The three, Bridges buries it from three-point range. Bridges got 12.
I'll tell you, the ability to act quickly, to get your shot up as soon as you make the catch, it's beautifully done by Bridges.
And here's Herder outside. Good, and it's Fox who picks up the assist.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give him from behind the arc.
Williams, a screen on Fox. Bridges inside. He's covered by Murray. And it's Sabonis with the ball for Sacramento. It's a one-point game. After this one, they're off to Philadelphia to take on the 76ers. And that game will be game 3 of 5 away from home. A moment now to hear from our sideline reporter, Hall of Famer, David Ogden. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Brandon Miller was a one-and-done in Alabama. He put on numbers and put on weight. He said, coming into college, I couldn't really take bumps, at least not college bumps. I know building muscle mass is key. Done adding muscle and layers to his game. He says it's all about the work. That's the only way you get better. Kevin?
That's a good focus. Thanks, D.A. Wants to get it to Herder and down. Murray for three. Another three for Sacramento.
And Murray makes that catch and shoot jumper look much easier than it actually is.
Rozier against Fox. Now, here's Rozier. He's got 12. Miller, no up. Fox finds Barnes. Back to Fox. Off target with his three.
But only the first miss of the second half. They've come out here with authority.
Miller with a wide open look. That's good. And it's Rozier with the assist. And that's now 7 points from Brandon Miller. Timeout called by the Kings. Some of the numbers for De'Aaron Fox.
And guys, his effective field goal percentage is trending in the wrong direction over the past 5 games. Shot discipline hasn't been the best. He'll be looking to play a smarter game tonight.
Kicks it to Barnes. Good on the triple. Barnes has got the lead up to 1 now for Sacramento.
That's called working the catch and shoot game to perfection. Barnes on balance and on point with his shot mechanics.
Miller, the pass to Rozier. Tried to come right back with the three of his own, but it's no good. The pass to Murray for the three. Rebound by Williams. Williams has got 7 rebounds in the game. Williams sends a screen for Rozier. Target from outside. The Kings have gone 5 of 7 from the field in the third quarter. Let's see if they can keep it up. The kick out to Fox. Hell good with the triple.
I'll tell you, his shot is just lost right now. There's just no consistency. Amazing that they're still up in this basketball game.
The shot's good. Williams has got 10.
Hey guys, he has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip.
The Kings trailing. Here's Fox. Sweet little floater.
And that little teardrop.
had it back at Kentucky, and boy, is he perfecting it at this level.
Now Rozier. He's got 12. Pass to Miller. Sabonis with the steal. An even three-on-three break. Got the bucket. And he's got a free throw coming up as well.
And sometimes Fox just can't be contained. I mean, he plays with so much heart and passion and terrific at scoring even when he gets bodied up.
Washington's checked in for Terry Rozier. And a change for Sacramento. Muggs checked in for Barnes. Passes it to Washington. For Murray. That one rolling around and runs out. Kings leading now by four. Outside Fox. Pass to Sabonis. Back to Fox. Uses the glass to finish the layup. 15 points in the game.
All right, defensively now, you've got to find a way to slow this guy down because he's putting it to you.
Boy, Fox is so quick off the floor.
Charlotte's gotten the third quarter to fall to the tune of 50% here in the third quarter. They've made 3 of 6. Here's Miller. Shot to stop the run. Up and in on the work. Miller's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Now that's how you pick up second chance points. Stay active and be ready as soon as the shot goes up.
Three-pointer, Fox drills the three-pointer. And the Kings lead by 9.
Hard to imagine them losing this game if they can keep shooting like that.
Martin wide open, he fires, and right away they match it with a three-pointer of their own.
Their three-point percentage has taken a big leap here in this second half.
And the foul called on Brandon Miller. That's foul number 2 for him.
Yeah, clearly he had an established position there.
Glad we got the chance to see that remarkable rejection.
And that has got to help the morale of this team. Let's see if that sets up a run here.
Sacramento making some changes. Kyle comes in for Keegan Murray. And Chris Duarte subbed in for Kevin Herter. Outside, Fox. Here's the pass to Monk. Good, and a nice assist from Fox. Monk's got 6.
Yeah, this looks like a pregame shoot-around with all the threes they're allowed.
We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Hefty move. Smith, no good.
I tell you what, the defense should send Christmas cards for that miss.
Back from outside. The rebound by Richard. A big time effort for De'Aaron Fox, providing a lot of energy for Sacramento. His production has been flowing as he's tallied 20 points and looks to be planning for more. We'll return shortly. Back to Monk. Pass to Duarte. Here's the is uncalled. Down to five on the shot clock. On for three, a rebound by Washington.
And the great shooters know when they got that opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
First personal foul.
And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Kings.
Their accuracy in this one has just been on another level. I mean, the three ball keeps falling, and the defense just hasn't been able to run them off the line.
I think it's also important we mention the number of assists this group has tallied. Their offense continues to just hum along right now.
And the Kings making a change here. McGee's checked in. And he sinks the second. And it's Fox with the ball for the Kings. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Wiles kicks to Fox. Three-pointer. It's rebounded by Sharp. Washington's got his fourth rebound at that last one here tonight. Passes it to McGowan. And that one is good.
Unselfishness can be infectious. Terrific teamwork.
Sacramento leading by 4. Fox dishes to Monk. Good, and it's Fox who picks up the assist. Fox has got his assist totals piling up. 11 now for him. Only shooting with confidence, 50% in the third so far. Smith outside. Just about 1.5 minutes.
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam, using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there. Sure. Duarte back to Fox. A three-pointer off the mark.
When you're not in rhythm with the three ball, why are you fired up from there?
And that one drops.
Rozier in a real rhythm offensively. That's problematic for the defense.
Now a timeout called by Sacramento. The short rest, very important, and one of the benefits of this part of the game is getting on the same page with your team, all having the chance to hydrate with Gatorade. Replenish your energy for the late game push. And the Hornets making a change here. Williams is checked in. Lance checked in for the Kings. Kevin Herter comes in for Duarte. The latest now from our sideline reporter, David Aldridge. David, it's all yours. Take it away.
Hey, thanks, guys. Was able to hear Mark Brown during the break. Now, with this game up for grabs, coach told his guys to think positive. He said, "We know this game is ours, fellas. We earned it. I need you to show me right now that you want this." They get it done. We'll see, guys.
Thank you, David. Fox. And the basket is good. Fox has got 14 points now in the second half.
And he gives up pounds to a lot of guys defending him, but that has never kept Fox from being in attack mode.
And Aaron Fox gets the whistle that time. That's his first foul.
First personal foul. Second team foul. Substitution on the court.
And the Hornets with possession here. Trailing by 5. Bridges against one. That's good from Bridges on the assist by Mike. 14 points for Miles Bridges.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
Miles, no good. Hornets have gotten absolutely head out. Shoot the ball here in the fourth. A perfect 6-for-6. Miller, no luck. Sacramento leading by 3. Over to the left wing. The wide open look here for Fox. From outside, off the mark. It's been a nice stretch for them offensively.
I mean, the communication's great. The movement's been really good. This is solid team basketball.
Miller, no luck. Sacramento's got some tough luck from 3-point range. In the fourth quarter, they've hit just 1 of 6 from deep. Bridges with the steal. And Bridges with a clear path to the basket. Timeout called by the Kings. Sacramento making some changes. Sabonis, he's checked in for Alex Len. Murray comes in for Lyles. And it's Harrison Barnes in for Malik Monk. Here's Fox driving in.
lets it go from deep. And Fox is good for three. Fox has got 5 points now in the quarter.
And such a flush shooter. I mean, he is.
Is a screen Fox. Rozier for three. And the Hornets miss again.
Simply put, a bad shot pass. They all know they can get a better one.
Herder passes to Fox. Sabonis. And he finishes nicely on the run. And the Kings lead by six.
No fear under duress. Big time moment. And DeMontis Sabonis delivers.
Rozier. It counts. And now they trail by just four.
No way, Rozier would have grabbed in a big spot than himself, and he delivers.
And a replay from Fox. Another miss by Fox.
He needs to drive to the rim. The shot just not going.
And the basket by Rozier.
And you can't get a better bucket than that.
Could be a turnover.
Critical position right here.
Bridges. Yes!
What you love is Miles Bridges has kept the score on the gas pedal. Started out scoring well and continues to keep the pressure on.
23 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Rozier against Fox. Outside to win it. Oh, couldn't sink the shot, and we're going to overtime. And that's going to do it for regulation. So we are headed to overtime. We'll be back shortly live from Spectrum Center. Time in what has been a stirring contest.
Here we go.
Fox in the backcourt with Herder to his side. Barnes is in the front court along with Murray, and it's Sabonis in at the five. Rozier for three, and DeMontis Sabonis pulls it down. Sabonis has got 11 rebounds in the game. From past the arc, it's rebounded by Charlotte. Rozier's got four rebounds not tonight. This is to Bridges. Back to Rozier. Oh, and almost had a 4-point play right there. There's one line and a chance for three.
Well, you love Terry Rozier drawing the contact in that instance. Gets himself an opportunity at the foul line.
It's the second from the line. And he nails the third.
You must embrace the pressure and knock down critical free throws. Nicely done.
The pass to Herder. For three, Murray. Gets rebounded by Charlotte. Martin's got four rebounds in this game. Rozier with the ball. Guarded by Fox. And stolen by Murray. And here we go. Fast break. Murray's got it. And he gets contact. And the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming in.
Really out of the right place. Defensively, if you can't block, force him to the line.
First one, boy, he wanted that one to fall. That's good, going 1-2 from the line, and that brings them within two.
Only down
two now, but that miss might come back to haunt them. If they don't get a stop, it's back to a two-possession.
Here's Miller outside. And Sacramento with the rebound.
And even without that three-ball dropping for him, the defense should have done more on that last play.
Sabonis keeps the lead. Let's it go with a three. Nailed from three-point land.
3 points.
And the Kings lead by one. So Rozier will bring it up for Charlotte. From downtown. And again, the Hornets missing. The Kings have gone 1-4 from the floor since the start. Pass to Barnes. Fires the three. And another three for Sacramento. Sacramento
saw the opportunity to put this away and did not turn it down.
Yeah, playing with great energy and great effort. And as a coach, you love to see this from your team every single night.
And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touch by Williams.
And always a bit of risk on those long passes. Lucky that he couldn't come up with it there.
Here's Fox with plenty of space. Good, and it's Sabonis with the assist that time.
Late in the game, up big, they continue to attack.
And as a result, they may be facing just a little bit less resistance right now. They are having their way. Never one to shy away. Terry Rozier says, I've got the answer right here.
And now we've got the intentional foul.
Second personal foul.
And no good as the first free throw missing for him. We'll see if he can handle the second.
Shooting for Sacramento.
And the second of two is good. And increases their lead to six. And the Hornets call time here. They're trailing by six. 20 seconds left in the first overtime. Action has been terrific. What do you think, guys?
They need a quick basket here.
Well, preferably a three, right? If there's a clean look, take it.
Goes up off the inbound.
Shot there off the drive.
Here's Sacramento, and they stop the clock as soon as they can with the intentional foul.
Yeah, you have to do that, though. You can't just let them dribble
in. And the first of two, no good. Heartbreak. So he comes up empty, missing both.
High pressure moment here from Aaron Fox. No need to rush, just focus on the hoop. And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over.
And I think that's the one thing every player is searching for, consistency. They're giving this guy a chance to carry the offense once again.
So the first one drops, and then it's a three-point lead. And a tough break as his second attempt at the line, no good.
And no secret here, guys. They've got to get a three if we're going to get yet another overtime.
So it's the Kings taking the W in a close one. And they had some nervous moments down the stretch, but things finally came together for them in overtime.
Yeah, probably didn't anticipate that this one would be that close down the wire. But give them credit, they were able to regroup in that overtime, and this win has to feel satisfying.
And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldrin, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. As we leave you with our New Balance Player of the Game, De'Aaron Fox.